Glory to God in the highest heaven, and peace on earth for all those pleasing him. Turn from your sins, the kingdom of God is coming soon. God desires and calls us to be closer to him during this Lenten season. Let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, we come to you with open hearts that express our desire to have a closer, personal relationship with you. We make room for you in our lives, especially now, as we begin our Lenten journey. In your Son's name we pray. Amen. Our hymn this morning is number 383, More About Jesus. Then Jesus, full of the Holy Spirit, left the Jordan River, being urged by the Spirit out into the barren wastelands of Judea, where Satan tempted him for 40 days. He ate nothing all that time and was very hungry. Satan said, "If you are God's son, tell this stone to become a loaf of bread." But Jesus replied, "It is written in the scriptures, other things in life are much more important than bread." Then Satan took him up and revealed to him all the kingdoms of the world in a moment of time. And the devil told him, "I will give you all these splendid kingdoms and their glory, for they are mine to give to anyone I wish, if you will only get down on your knees and worship me." Jesus replied, "We must worship God and him alone. So it is written in the scriptures." Then Satan took him to Jerusalem, to a high roof of the temple, and said, "If you are the Son of God, jump off. For the scriptures say that God will send his angels to guard you and to keep you from crashing to the pavement below." And Jesus replied, "The scriptures also say, do not put the Lord your God to a foolish test." When the devil had ended all the temptations, he left Jesus for a while and went away. God always adds his blessing to the reading of his holy word. Hymn number 33, My Faith Looks Up to Thee. Here we are in the wilderness of our Lenten journey, just like the people of Israel, who spent 40 years in the desert to prepare themselves for entry into God's promised land. Into the wilderness like Jesus, who spent 40 days in the desert to prepare himself for the ministry that lay ahead of him. We are entering in our own wilderness for 40 days as we prepare ourselves for Holy Week, Good Friday, and Easter. What does it feel like to you as you enter into this time of turning inwards to figure out your relationship with God? Are we excited? Are we nervous, or are we intimidated? Do we feel inadequate, or do we feel confident? It's our time to tune into our spiritual being by going deep within and really having a heart-to-heart, or many heart-to-hearts, with God. On Ash Wednesday, did we contemplate taking up something or leaving out something as our fast for the 40 days? The whatever it was that we gave up, is it something that needs to be changed in our living in order to make room for God in our lives? If we took up something, was it more time to be with Him, to read His holy word, to reflect on our personal relationship with Him? Are we going to have a hard look at our temptations? Because we sure know, Lent or not, temptations do not go away. Our scripture even told us about Jesus being tempted by the devil himself for the full 40 days. We are no different in that regard. He is always lurking about tempting us, and yes, indeed, sometimes gets through to us. Anything that takes place in our lives that take us away from God is considered to be that evil force. I remember Mrs. DeLong, I'm sure many of you do, who telling us in Sunday school here at Bayside Baptist to always be on the lookout for the evil one. We would leave here with our eyes wide open, and it was one of the scariest walks home. Jesus was up against the same force, a powerful evil one, that Jesus himself struggled with. It's always a battle when the devil's involved. Our struggle is as real as the struggle Jesus had in the wilderness. We have our work cut out for us, and we don't deny, but we better pray about it all the time. The devil was throwing lots of ideas out to Jesus to see if he'd grab any one of them. Kind of like quick rich schemes to get to the kingdom of God. Riches like material things. Then he offered Jesus power or an empire for a kingdom if he worshiped the devil. Jesus responded to this with, "Worship the Lord your God and serve nothing else." And then the third temptation of offering his followers a circus, entertainments as such with magic to attract people to church. Remember, Jesus said, "Do not put the Lord your God to the test." Jesus always stood firm. Through all of our temptations, our focus is on the cross of Christ. It is our symbol that reminds us of God's grace. We can expect to get peace from the cross, the true peace that Jesus gave to us by hanging on it and then dying. Our peace that brings each of us wholeness and salvation. Peace like no other. To know it is to give up our cravings for material things, for power, and for wanting to be satisfied all the time with entertainment and the very many distractions of this planet. When we work on it with a serious intent, we will find our peace, a peace that passes all understanding, a peace that slaps the devil right in the face. When we travel on our journey through Lent, we are looking for that peace of Christ, that peace that brings joy in unity with Him, in His suffering and death, His resurrection and victory over death. Though it is Lent, there are times when we realize the hope and mercy of God, those moments of unexpected joy that we might have. We may be surprised by joy, but our self-sacrifices serve no purpose unless, by laying aside this or that craving or desire, we are able to focus on our heart's deepest longing, unity with Christ. In Him, in His suffering and death, His resurrection and triumph, we find genuine joy. This is what Lent is all about. We can be surprised by joy, sacrificing ourselves as we focus on greater intimacy and unity with Christ, finding our truest joy in Jesus Christ alone. Make room for him. I'm not sure how you prepare each day for during Lent, but I do know that by even thinking about it can be a good start for all of us. When we feel alone in our journey, we know that Jesus felt the same feeling of aloneness in his 40 days of solitude. Through all of the temptations, he came out on top, and so can we. Testing God is not our mission here on earth, but testing ourselves certainly is when it comes to denying the work of evil and doing the work God has asked of us. When we follow Jesus, we are to help others. We are to love our enemies, and we are to spread the good news of Christ. The Holy Spirit guides us, just as Jesus was guided, and we need to declutter our minds, our hearts, and our lives to make room for goodness, all of the goodness, to enter through Christ. Leaving the wilderness, Jesus was full of the Holy Spirit. He had plenty of time and room to have one-on-one conversations with God. Luke 4, verses 18 and 19, where Jesus is speaking in the synagogue, and he says, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me. He has appointed me to preach good news to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted and to announce that captives shall be released, and the blind shall see, that the downtrodden shall be freed from their oppressors, and that God is ready to give blessings to all who come to him." Each day of Lent affords us the opportunity to wake up, to stop, and draw near to God before our feet even hit the floor. It's our time to reflect on our lives and how they mirror Jesus. It gives us the opportunity to grow spiritually and to deepen our own relationship with God. It's not to overwhelm us, because we know it's a live day-by-day world. I'll end with this short little prayer that I found, and I think it's a good reminder every day if we said this. It's called, "I will lean in." There is no author specified. I will lean in, retreat from the pressures I face, and move closer and deeper into your love. I will breathe out, refrain from the distractions I seek, and become open and receiving of your grace. I will linger, encircled by the depth of your care, and receive the endless nature of your mercy. I will whisper in the quiet of this sanctuary or at home, and be honest and real in your presence. I will listen, awaken all my senses to your voice, and become expectant and hopeful of your kingdom work in my life. Amen. Our hymn, "Yield Not to Temptation," number 399.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Generous Father, we bring to you our tithes and offerings to be used to bring glory to your name. Allow them to help with our ministry and with our outreach ministry. Bless our offerings at this time, O God. We pray through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Reduced her pain, I guess we can say, and hopefully will be home with us soon. So we will keep Linda in our prayers for sure. She's having a long haul in there. I know she doesn't like the food, and she's surviving on porridge is what I'm told. So prayers for Linda. Let us pray. Almighty God, you are truly amazing. Not only did you create the entire universe with nothing more than the sound of your voice, but you truly care about your creation, each and every one of us. You are holy. You are good. You are true. You are love. You are peace. And you never ever change. Thank you for everything you are. And thank you for loving us. We thank you for all of the many, many blessings you have given to us. Blessings way beyond what we could ever hope to deserve. Thank you for food on our tables, roofs over our heads, heat during this cold weather, employment, and employment support for those not working. You are such a good God. Thank you for always taking such good care of us. During this time of Lent, help us to draw closer to you in everything that we do. In everything we choose to say, read, or watch. Help us rid ourselves of the many distractions so we can be nearer and nearer to you. Help us rid our hearts and minds of clutter so we can have more room for you and all that you mean to us. Through this dark time, we find ourselves in the wilderness at times. We pray that you give us the strength and the intent to move forward to brighter days. We pray that through time alone and reflection, we realize the ultimate joy that is Easter. Healing God, we bring to you people in our lives that need your healing hand. We pray for Linda Mosier, asking that she gets rid of what is causing her pain so she can get home here to Bayside. We pray for John, who is here waiting for her. We bring Jess to you and pray that the chemo is working and that she feels more energetic with every new day. Lord, we pray for seniors who are aging and tending to forget things or repeat things. Give them patience and their family members understanding. There are others we bring to you now. For all people grieving and living with mental illness, we ask that you help them endure and know through you there is a peace beyond all understanding. And we pray that more social services are made available for them to access. Bless us. Bless this church during these uncertain times. Guide us as we travel on our journey with Jesus to the cross. We believe and we accept your call to us. Hear us as we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, power and glory, forever and ever. Our final hymn this morning, number 375, Draw Me Nearer.
Thank you.
to temptation. Give up or take up something that needs changing in order to be the people God wants us to be. Let's allow the Holy Spirit to lead us into God's presence until we're called home. Make room for Him in your life. Amen.